Do I even need to say it? It's one hell of a jungle out there. And today we're going to go over the tools and the equipment to survive it. Let's jump into this. So no doubt, unless you've been under a rock, 2020 and 2021 have been pretty crazy years. And so today I thought I'd be showing you guys my EDC essentials for surviving in this new age that we're in. Because to be honest, I hate to sound more like a pessimist than anything, but it doesn't look like it's getting any better from here. So let's talk about my handful of items that are EDC essentials. Now in this video, this isn't so much of an EDC update as much as it is, this is a video of me going over the types of equipment that I deem essential for every single day carrying on your body. So let's jump into it. Now this first one's probably not going to be a huge shocker by any means, but it is a gun and of course the holster. Now we'll touch on the holster in a little bit, but I wanted to talk about the gun specifically. Now I think any gun in general is important when it comes to EDC, and I think a lot of people have thought that, at least here in the US, because gun sales have been record-breaking in 2020, and I think 2021 will probably only help double that. But in general, guns have been very important, and if you've been keeping up with the news, even, you know, more conservative outlets, you know, you will see protesters, riots, crazy things happening. So I'll talk about the gun because I've picked a gun that is, at least in my opinion, fitting of the situation. And I think that, you know, we have to update our EDC as things change. And so if the environment changes and it requires more of us, it's important to adapt your EDC in that way. So over the past, from 2019 to 2021, I have actually kind of gone full circle with my guns. In 2019, I started out with a CZP-10C and it was, you know, 15+1. I went in 2020, at least the beginning of 2020, I went over to a single stack 9mm that had 9 rounds, and now I'm kind of back to a more higher capacity handgun. Now this is a Glock 19X and I am rocking the 19 round magazine, which is a 17 round magazine with a +2 extension and one in the chamber, which means that this is a 20 round capacity handgun. Now some people might say this is a little bit overboard, and I might agree, it's a 20 rounds is quite a bit, but if, like I said, you've been keeping up with news, you'll know that some of these riots, some of these crazy incidences are definitely led by mobs of malicious people. And if you just so happen to find yourself in a mob of malicious people, we're no longer talking about self-defense against one or two people. We're talking about self-defense against potentially 5, 6, 7 people. And so having a gun that can match or have a higher capacity than something like 9 rounds is important, at least in my opinion. So I've gone a little bit on the heavy side, but I am carrying a Glock 19X, like I said, with a 19 round magazine, +1 in the chamber, and I can conceal carry this fairly well, especially with wintertime apparel. This thing does bury pretty well, but like I said, I like that kind of insurance policy that, you know, if I find myself up against multiple aggressors or if a mob is trying to do whatever to me, I have a gun that can adequately defend myself in those situations. So in addition to the handgun, I'm also carrying an extra magazine, as one does, and this is just a standard 17 round magazine. So altogether, I have 37 rounds here. Once again, probably seems a little bit excessive, and it might be, but ultimately, at the end of the day, it's having the adequate amount of ammunition to defend yourself against realistic threats. And, you know, if this was 2018, 2019, even 2017, you know, I would say you probably don't need that much ammo. But being that now mobs and social unrest are such a prominent and preeminent thing, if you happen to find yourself in the middle of that, it's nice to have something that can take care of it. So moving over to the holsters for both the magazine and the gun itself, this is, I went a little bit bougie here with this holster, but this is a Milt Sparks Summer Special 2, and this is a horsehide leather and shark trim to it. So shark leather and horse hide leather, which is pretty nice. I definitely like that. It's a nice touch. And so that is the holster for the handgun, and the holster for the magazine is just a Tolster spare mag holster. So it's an inside the waistband thing. And of course I chose a full leather holster because I am a really big fan of full leather. I love the way it feels, and it's much, much more comfy to carry than something that's made out of kydex, especially appendix. So that is the holster for that gun. That is the gun and the magazine in its holster. So that's number one, the most essential piece to carry. Now next to that would be a knife, at least for me. And I have plenty of knives, and once again, being that this is an essentials video, I'm not necessarily selling you on the knife that is here, but just for the sake of the video, this is a Blade HQ Benchmade Bug Out 535, and this is like a limited edition. And this one in particular is gray G10 with a 20 CV blade, and pretty nice knife, good box opener. I do like the Bug Out because you can really throw it in a pocket and forget about it, but it has a lot of high-end materials, so things like 20 CV won't really need to be sharpened for a very long time. So definitely love this blade, but you know, there's many different knives out there. It's just more important that you carry a knife, carry something. It doesn't necessarily have to be as high-end or fancy as, you know, a limited edition kind of knife. So that is my knife, but a knife is a very important option, or a very important tool. Now this next one's gonna get a little bit more controversial. Some people may like it, some people may not. You may agree or disagree, but it looks like masks are here to stay for a while. And while I definitely don't love wearing masks when I have to, the mask that I wear is a Mechanics Wear. This is the black multicam version. So this is a pretty good mask. I love repping Mechanics anytime I can. I'm a pretty big Mechanics fan, whether we're talking about gloves or we're talking about masks. I think they do a pretty darn good job at making tough products and things that look pretty cool. I mean, this is black multicam, and I definitely like it. I also like that this mask covers a large portion of your face. It's not like a surgical mask where it just covers, you know, just your face. This thing covers like half your dang face, and it is pretty, pretty nice. So that's the mask that I wear when I wear masks. And like I said, depending on how you feel about it, you may not like it, but it does seem that masking up is here to stay, at least for a little while. So that is the next part of the EDC essentials. Okay, so moving over to the next two parts are the phone and the watch. So we'll go with the phone here. Now this is a iPhone 11 Pro Max, and the primary reason I went with the Pro Max is just due to battery life. This thing just gets killer battery life. You guys can probably see here, hopefully, pretty well. You can see that I've just got off work, and you know, this has gone through a full work day, and you can already see that this phone has 80% battery. So what I like about the Pro Max in particular is that it has a very long lasting battery life. I can easily get 2 days out of it, if not 3 days, with the amount I use my phone. So really nice option, but I definitely don't have to go with something like that. I just like phone because it keeps me in touch, and you know, it helps me communicate with my world. And at the same time, you know, I think having a phone is important in this day and age, if nothing else, because it helps keep you alert and active to the craziness that ensues. As a side note to that, the watch that I have here is a Apple Watch Series 5, and this one is a cellular enabled, but once again, I like watches a lot because it helps. I like smartwatches a lot because they help keep me in tune with what's going on in the world. I can see notifications when people, you know, bust open the door and they're like, have you seen the latest? What's on TV or whatnot? I can say I didn't, but I do know what's going on because my watch, you know, gets updates, so I understand what's going on. And I like having a smartwatch because in the medical field, there's a lot of times where we really can't use our phones or look at our phones or interact with our phones. So having a smartwatch allows me to still check notifications, respond to text messages, do stuff like that while being discreet about it. So it keeps me in the loop without having to have my phone directly on me or, you know, use my phone directly. So I like it for that reason. But either way you slice it, I think a smartwatch and I think a good, solid running phone are really essential for EDC in the new world. So the next part is the flashlight. Now, like I said, this is an EDC Essentials video, so I try not to give direct recommendations. I will explain what I carry, but this is one where I'm going to break the rules just a little bit because I think that this tool or this flashlight is such a win, so I'm going to at least recommend it. So this particular flashlight that we're looking at right now is the Phoenix LD30, and I think that this flashlight is a really big win. It's about $80. You can get a little bit cheaper on Amazon, but this flashlight, for a flashlight that fits nearly in the palm of my hand, you guys can see there, you know, very, very small flashlight, uses one CR, one 18650, and it has 1600 lumen output in this little guy. So this thing has an insane output with a very small package, and like I said, one 18650 is an incredible little package. So if you guys are looking for a quality light, I know Olight has had some recall issues, this little guy right here is definitely one to check out because it has an insanely high output for its very small size. So the Phoenix LD30 is what I carry, but regardless, especially this time of year where it's really dark out, as you can see, it's important to have a really solid flashlight because you need to be able to see where you're going, or, you know, to use it in tandem potentially with a handgun. You know, there's tons and tons and tons of applications for a good flashlight, and having a super high output is always very handy. So Phoenix LD30 is what I use, but a flashlight is definitely an EDC essential without a doubt. So another one that COVID has kind of helped spawn more importance is a pen. Now, you definitely don't need anything fancy like this Maritac Embassy, but having a really quality or having a good pen on you, having a personal pen on you, is very important in this day and age. And I like having a pen, like my own pen, on me because you still have to sign a lot of paperwork. Still, I find myself writing quite a bit on whatever different things come up during the day. And it's nice to have my own pen. I know where this has been. I know how many people have touched it. I know the general cleanliness of this item. So having your own pen is pretty nice because, especially like I said, in these COVID times, you know, having something that you know where it's been, how many people have touched it, is pretty handy. Okay, so beginning to wind it down, we're looking at the last few items here. So headphones. These may not seem like an EDC essential to everyone, but for me, in my opinion, they definitely are. And they are still the Aftershocks Airs. I really like these for wireless headphones. Some people may not like them because they have the band on it, but they get really great battery life, and because they are Aftershocks, they are bone conduction, and so they're one of the few wireless headphones out there that do not sit in your ear, and therefore, you know, your natural hearing is not impaired with these headphones. So I like the fact that, you know, you can go out about your day doing things every day as you do, and you can have a podcast, you can have, you know, music, you can have a YouTube video going, but yet you can still hear out of your ears. So I like these things a lot, and definitely a part of my EDC. I use them too much for them to really not be. Like I said, that's why I kind of consider them an EDC essential. Okay, so the next thing is a lighter. Now, I've said this before in other EDC essential videos, a lighter is really important, even if you don't smoke. I don't smoke, but having a lighter, even something like a Bic Mini, is just really nice to have because in case you find yourself in a survival situation, in case you ever need it, having flames at your fingertips really can be a big game changer. So this is a little nod to my survival kind of tendencies, and by and large, my EDC essentials are designed for a city life or an urban life. This is not so much designed for, you know, like out in the wilderness. So having a lighter is nice in case you find yourself in a circumstance where you need to start a fire. So that is why it makes it to the EDC essentials, even though realistically, at least for me, this does not see that much use. Okay, so the last thing, but not least, is a water bottle. Hydration, hydration, hydration. And a shameless plug to my channel's sticker, but this is a Hydro Flask in particular. I'm not a huge fan of Hydro Flasks. I have this one. Usually I use Nalgene's, but I do like the abilities and the properties of a, you know, kind of Hydro Flask that keeps drinks colder or keeps drinks warmer. You know, you can hear the ice rattling around in this one, But either way, whether it's a hydro flask, a Nalgene, or any other type of water bottle, water bottles are really important. It's important to stay hydrated. And it's, once again, similar to the headphones, you know, people might not think of a water bottle, quality water bottle, as an EDC essential, but I simply use it too much for it not to be an EDC essential. So that's why I categorize it as an EDC essential. So anyways, guys, hopefully you've enjoyed this video going over some of the EDC essentials that I think are very important in the year 2021. Some are a little bit more topical to the current climate, and some are just things that you should always have on you, you know, regardless to whether COVID is here or not. You know, a flashlight's always good to have, a knife is always good to have, and hell, even a gun is always good to have. You know, I mean, even if we're not talking about crazy mobs doing crazy things, you never know what you'll have to defend yourself against. So having a good quality handgun, or, you know, having a good quality handgun on you is still important regardless to the year. I just think that, you know, having a little bit of extra capacity nowadays is important because you just don't know. So anyways, guys, hopefully you've enjoyed this video. Hopefully this has kind of sparked some ideas. I like to make these videos because I'm trying to get people to see, you know, different things that they can incorporate into their lives to make their lives either easier, more seamless, or just more well-rounded. So anyways, guys, hopefully you've enjoyed this video. And as always, God bless, and I'm out.